So I sit here at the bridge, the Martin Luther King, John Lewis, and other civil rights heroes crossed. Let's take a minute to think back on those days. Much rougher than these times. We survived and we thrived. I'm a perfect example of that myself. African American man gets his doctorate degree in 2018. Almost considered easy compared to what it took to get a doctorate degree back then. I guess it depends on your perspective and the color of your skin, how you see that. I'm gonna sit here a while longer and look around and try to drink in the history. It's only by drinking in the history can we remember it into tomorrow and sharing it with the younger people coming along and make sure that they never forget. It's almost written into our DNA, but gotta make sure. Leave the bridge without walking across it myself in the Selma. Can't really say I know what they felt when they did it so long ago, but I can hazard a guess that walking for freedom and respect, but in their hearts I'm sure they felt a lot of fear and apprehension of what was waiting on them. That's one of the key points of doing great things. There's an inherent fear in everybody, but it's the ability to move beyond that fear and grasp purpose and focus on making things happen and moving things forward. In this country, we find too often people want things to stay like they are, keep the status quo. One thing is certain, is in time. Time always moves forward. It waits for no man, no thought, no ideation, no belief. Time is the master to all fates. It's pretty interesting. This is a big, big river. The whole area is pretty interesting. Just getting to see this is pretty exciting for me and interesting. But even in this, with all the traffic that's going by, people living their lives, you can take a moment and reach back in history and try to connect. In my view, we as a people need to do this so we can get a better focus on what we should be fighting for, what we should be focused on, and that's freedom, respect, and the ability to progress in life for everyone, unhindered by the color of their skin, their beliefs, or ideation. Everybody should have a right to become somebody in America. It's here for that, it serves that purpose. And it's a beacon to the world. Right now we're going through some changes. So many things are going on that are so negative. But even in that, we should keep a positive mentality about moving forward. Today has been pretty interesting. I had a chance to stop and pray with some elders on the other side of this bridge, and that was a pleasure. When I told them I just got my doctorate degree on the 18th of August, they were so excited for me. And then I told them it was important for me, even though I got my doctorate degree, to come here and see this place. Try to feel the struggle that gave me the pathway to get that doctorate degree. Without these struggles, I wouldn't stand before you today with a doctorate degree. Wouldn't have had the ability. We'd have still been oppressed. Sacrifice. Question is, are you willing to make it? It comes down to an individual.
I now call Dr. Sorrell to the microphone.